Hello students, in this video I am going to tell you how to find the solution of matrices, solution of determinants. So here we have to find the values for x, y and z. If in this case we have to firstly find the value of determinant, then value for determinant for x, then y, then z. Just see in the video how we do that. Firstly we have to find the value of determinant, as I told you. So write the coefficients of x and y and z only. So we have 1, 3, 4, 2, minus 2 and 2, 3, 1 and 1. Now solve it. So we have 1, minus 2, minus 2, then it is minus 2. We have 3, 1s are 3, minus 4. Now I think you know how to find the determinant, so I am not going to explain you. 3, 2 is 6. Plus 4 2s are 8. If you want to see some more videos, you can go to the description box. There is a link, minus 4, and you can check it if you want. Minus 1 plus 3 into 14. Clear? So what we have now, we have minus 4 plus 2 plus 3 4s are 12. 3 1s are 3, 1 4. That means 44 minus 4. That means we have 40. So now we have to find now the values for dx, dy and dz. Now we see how we calculate it. At the place of x, that means we just leave the coefficients of x, okay? And in that place we write the coefficient which are written after equal to. That means we have 6, 2, 7 here, and we have to solve this matrix in the same way. So we have 6, minus 2, minus 2, minus 2. We have 2 1s are 2, minus 7, plus 3, 2 2s are 4, plus 7 2s are 14. Okay, now solve it. 6 into minus 4, minus 2, minus 5, plus 3 into 18. So we have minus 24, plus 10, plus 3 8s are 3 8s are 24, 2 3 8s are 3, 4 1 5, 54. So we have minus 24 plus 64, so we have 40. So dx you can say it is 40. Okay, when we replace that position from the x, we write it as dx. Now similarly, find the two values for dy and dz. For this, we have to replace this one and write 6 to 7 here. And write it dy here, and in place of this we write again the coefficient of x, that is 1, 3 and 4, 1, 3 and 4. And find similarly, we have 1, 2 1s are 2, minus 7, minus 6, 3 1s are 3, minus 4, plus 3, 7 3s are 21, minus 8. Now just find it, we have minus 5, minus 6, minus 1, plus 3 into 13. So we have minus 5 plus 6, 13 threes are 39. So we have plus 1 plus 39, that is 40. So again the value for dy is 40. Now find the value for dz. For dz, we replace it and write it here 6, 2, 7, and coefficient of y 2, minus 2 and 2. Clear? So we dz, we have 1, 7 2s are 14, minus 4, minus 2, 7 3s are 21, minus 8, plus 6, 3 2s are 6, plus 4 2s are 8. So we have minus 18, minus 11 is 13 into 2, plus 6 into 14. So we have minus 18, minus 26, plus 24, plus 6, 7, 8. So we have 8, 6, 14, 2, 1, 3, 4, plus 84. That means we again have 40. Now we have to see how will we find the values for x, y and z. So for x, y and z, we find for x dx over d, for y dy over d, and for z dz over d. So we have 40 over 40, then 40 over 40, then 40 over 40. So in all the cases we have x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 and z is equals to 1. So in this way you find the solution of equations. One thing more, in this video I want to conclude that if the value of d is equals not equal to 0 and d1, d2, that means dx, dy and dz, they also not equal to 0, then it has unique solution. That means it is consistent. That means we get the values for x, y and z. Now second case, when we have value of determinant is value of dx, value of dy and value of dz all equal to 0, then it has infinite solutions. That means it has lot of solutions and it is inconsistent. It is inconsistent. Clear? Now if d is equal to 0, but either any of them, dx or dy or dz, is not equal to 0, then it is no solution. Okay, in this types, in this way we do the questions. Just thank you. Hi students, good morning again, and in this video I am going to tell you how you will find the inverse of the matrix. Let's go start. There is a matrix and we have to find the inverse of this matrix. The formula for inverse of the matrix is, inverse of the matrix is adjoint of the matrix over determinant of the matrix. That means, for example, this is A, the inverse is this, and adjoint of A over determinant of A. Okay, you can also write in this way. Clear? Now firstly, you know how will you find the determinant of matrix, so I will calculate it later. I am going firstly find the adjoint of matrix. What is the adjoint of matrix? Adjoint of matrix is the transpose of cofactor matrix. Clear? Now firstly, in this way we have to find the cofactor matrix. Now just see how we evaluate and how we find that. Firstly, I am going to find the cofactor matrix. This is a 3 cross 3 matrix. For example, this is A. So as you know, this is A 1 1, and for that we have 2 3 1 and 1. So it calculate 2 and the 2 minus 3, we have minus 1. Now for Y 1 2, that means for this we write minus outside, we have 1 3 3 and 1, solve it, 1 minus 9 and we have minus 8. Now for 1 3 we have 1 2 3 1, 1 2 3 and 1, and for that we have 1 minus 6, that is minus 5. Okay, now in the matrix we got minus 1, minus 8 and minus 5. Now just find for the second row, for the 2 1, 2 2 and 2 3. Here what we write, but this is plus, this is minus, this is plus, then it is minus again. So we kept here minus, this is plus and this is minus. For 1, we have 1, 2 and 1 and 1. Just see over here. For 1, we have 1, 2 and 1 and 1. We have to find 1, 2 1 and 1. Okay, for this one we have 0, 2, 3 and 1. 0, 2, 3 and 1. For this one we have 0, 1, 3 and 1. 0, 1, 3 and 1. Now calculate the values for them. We have minus outside 1, 1s are 1, minus 2, that means we have positive 1. And here we have 0 minus 6, that means negative of 6. And here we have 0 minus 3, that is positive of 3. Now write down here, we have 1 minus 6 and plus 3. Okay, now we have to find the third row. Clear? For the third row, we have 3, 1, 3, 2 and 3, 3. Okay, and here again, this is minus, plus, minus, then it is plus, minus, plus. So we write minus over here. And in the matrix boxes, for 3 we have 1 and 2 and 2 and 3. For 3 and 2 we have 0, 2, 1 and 3. 0, 2, 1 and 3. For 3, 3, for this we have 0, 1, 1 and 2. 0, 1, 1 and 2. Okay, be careful in writing the matrices. Okay, now just solve it. 3 1s are 3 minus 4, that means we have minus 1. Here we have 0 minus 2, that is plus 2. And here we have 0 minus 1, that is minus 1. So we have minus 1, 2 and minus 1. What is this matrix? This matrix is the cofactor matrix. This is not that joint. This is the cofactor matrix. And what are the things we have done? We find the minors of the cofactor matrix. These are the minors of the cofactor. And when we got this type of matrix, this is the cofactor matrix. Now, for to finding the adjoint of the matrix, we just transpose the cofactor matrix. Okay, so in transposing we make rows into column and column into rows. So minus 1, minus 8 and minus 5, it comes over here in this way. And 1, minus 6 and 3, minus 1, 2 and minus 1. Okay, so this is the adjoint of the matrix. Now we have to find the determinant of the matrix in order to find the inverse. So for the determinant of matrix we write 0, 2 1s are 2, minus 3, minus 1, 1 1s are 1, minus 3 3s are 9, plus 2, 1 1s are 1, minus 6. So we have 0 plus 8 and 2 into minus 5, that means we have 8 minus 10, that is minus 2. Okay, so the inverse of the matrix is we have minus 2. So we just replace all the minus signs. 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2, this is 4, this is 3, this is minus 1. This is 5 by 2, this is 3 over minus 2, and this is 1 over 2. So this is the inverse of the matrix, this. Okay, now just write it down. We have to find this with the elementary operations. I'm doing column wise. So we have 1 over here, we have to make it 0. So column R2, column C2 is equal to 2 times C1 minus C2. That means we have 1, 2 1s are 2, 1, 0, 2 1s are 2, 2 and it is 5. Then 2, it is minus 1. 2 2's are 4. 4 minus 3, that is 1. 1 minus 2 minus 1, that is minus 3 and 1. Okay, now we have to make it 0. So if we multiply it with 5 and subtract it, then we get 0. That means C3 is equal to 5 of C1 minus C3. So we have 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 1, minus 3, it is 0, 5 2s are 10, 10 minus 1, that is 9, 5 1s are 5, minus 5, minus 1, that is we have minus 6. Clear? Oh, sorry, one thing, we do the same operations here. We write 1, 0, 0 for C2, 2 times C1 minus C2. 2 1s are 2, so we have 2 over here, we have minus 1 over here, and 0 over here, here we have 0, 0, 1. Now in this case, we have to interchange only in C3, so we just write it as it is. Now 5 C1 minus C3, 5 C1, 5 1s are 5, 5 C1, so here it is. 5 1s are 5 and it is 0 and this is minus 1. The operations which I done with this matrix we also do with this matrix. Okay, so we now have this matrix 1 0 0. Now we have to bring it 0. Here it is, we have to do the 0. So for this if we multiply it with 2, with 2 and subtract with this. Okay, that means C1 is equal to C1 minus 2 times C2. So we write 1, 0, 0 as it is. Now C1. C1 minus 2 C2. So C1, this is 1 minus 2. That means 0. That means we again got 1. Okay. Now here 2 and 1. So we multiply. It is 2. It is 1. We multiply it with 2. 2 1s are 2 minus 2. That is 0. Okay. And 1 and 9, we write it as it is. And here minus 1, that means C1 minus 2 C2, that means we have minus 1 minus 2 into minus 3, that means minus 1 plus 3 to the 6, we have 5. So I write it over 5 minus 3 minus 6, and here we have to only change in C1, so we just write 2, 5, minus 1, 0, 0 minus 1 as it is. Now for this 1, C1 minus 2 C2. C1 minus 2 C2. That means 1 minus 4. That means we have minus 3 and 0 minus minus 1 into 2. That means we have plus 2 and here we have 0. Clear? Now in our matrix, what we have done, we make it 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and so now we have to make 9 as 0, and which is not possible. It can be possible. That means C3 is equal to C3 minus 9 times C2. Okay, so we have 1, 0, 5, 0, 1, minus 3. Because there is no change in column 1 and column 2, there is only change in column 3. Now column 3. C3 minus 9 times C2. That means C3 here is 0 minus 9 times 0. That means we have 0. And here we got 0. Now here, C3, that is minus 6 minus 9 into minus 3. We have minus 6 plus 9 threes are 27. That means 21. Clear? In this way we got the matrix, and the same operations we do with that matrix. That means we have minus 3, 2, 0, 2, minus 1, 0. Now for the operation C3. C3 is equal to minus 9, C2. C3 minus 9. C3 was 5, minus 9, 2 is 18. That means we have minus 13. So I write it over minus 13. Now 0, minus 9. So we have 9. Now here we have C3 minus 1. So we have minus 9. Okay. So the operations which we do in the in first matrix, we have to do the same operation in the second matrix. Now we got this one. Now here we have to write 0. Clear? For here 0, we multiply it with 5 and divide and. So we don't do in this way. We have to do only in this way. So how we make it 1? For this we have to make 1. And this we make 2, 0. So firstly we divide column C2, column C3 by 7. Column C3 gets column C3 over 7. So we have 1, 0, 0, not with 7, with 21. So 0, 5, 1 minus 3, 0, 1. So we here have minus 3, 2, 0, 2 minus 1, 0, minus 13 over 21, 9 over 21, minus 1 over 21. Now we make it both 0 and 0. So if we multiply it with 3 and add it, so it becomes 0. Now, we have the matrix 1 0 0 0 1 0 5 minus 3 1, and we got the matrix at the present time minus 3 2 minus 13 over 21 2 minus 1 9 over 21 0, 0, minus 1 over 21. Okay. So now we have to make the second column 0. For making this as a 0, if we multiply with 3 and add with this, so C2 is equal to C2 plus 3 times C3. So we have 105 C2, that means 0 plus 0, that means here we have 0. Now here we have 1 plus 0, that is 0, and here we have 3 into 3 plus 3, that is 0, and this matrix we written as it is. Okay, so now here we have first column and third column, just write it as it is. Minus 13 over 21,
3 3 are 9, 3 7 are 21. We have 3 over 7 minus 1 over 21. Now for C2 column. C2 plus 3 times C3. That means C2 plus 3 times C3. C2 that is 2 plus 3 into minus 13 over 21. So we have 7. 7 2s are 14 minus 13 over 7. So we have 1 over 7. Clear? Now similarly for the second column we have C2 that is minus 1 plus 3 into 3 over 7. We have minus 1 plus 3 3s are 9 over 7, that is minus 14 plus 9 over 7. That means 5 over 7. Now for the third we have 0, that is 0 plus 3 into minus 1 over 21, that means minus 1 over 7. Okay, because it is very essential to do the same operations to the other matrix. Now we have only just make it as 0. We make it as 0 by multiplying by this 5 and subtracting this. So we have C1 is equal to 5 times C3 minus C1. Okay, now let's see how we do this. So one thing it is clear, if we do the operations column wise, do only column wise. If we do the operations row wise, then do row wise. So we have to solve C1 is equal to 5C3 minus C1. So we have to change only in C1. So write C2 and C2, C3 as it is. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 1. Similarly here also, just write as it is. Minus 13 over 21, 3 over 7, minus 1 over 21, 1 over 7, minus 5 over 7, minus 1 over 7. So there is a change only in first column in both the cases. According to this, 5 times C3, if we multiply it with 5, that is 0, and minus C1. So it creates a problem. So just interchange, because we got the negative answer. So we change it in this way. That means C1 minus 5 times C3. So we again got 1 over here. In this case, it is all 0. So we get 0 and here we got 1. Clear? Now here also, now C1 minus 5C3. That means I can rub over here. Just watch, C1 minus 5C3. Now what is C1? This is minus 3 minus 5 into C3 minus 13 upon 21, because it is our C3. So we have minus 3 plus 3, 13 5 is 65 over 21. That means we have 3 1s are 3, 3 2 is 6 plus 65 over 21. That means 2 over 21. So we have here 2 over 21. Now second one, it is 2. So 2 minus 5 into C3, we have 3 over 7. That means 14 minus 15 over 7. That means minus 1 over 7. Now third one is 0. That is 0 minus 5 into minus 1 over 21. So we have 5 over 21. So I think you will got the concept that do one by one and you will get easily the inverse matrix. Okay, in this way we got the inverse of the matrix.